First off, what is a feral cat? A feral cat is one that cannot be handled by humans. They're essentially unsocialized. Although they are the same species as the domestic cat that some of you may share your home with, a feral cat's idea of a good time is not curling up with you on the bed on a cold, snowy evening. Their idea of a good time is hanging out with their cohorts and avoiding humans as much as possible, except in the case of food. Feral cats reside in colonies. Colony is a group of three or more sexually mature cats living in the same location. And by sexually mature, I mean 6 months of age or older. And feral cats establish a colony wherever there is a food source. This could be a dumpster. It can also be an overpopulation of small mammals, such as rats and mice. And a colony is considered managed if it is controlled by a trap, neuter, return program. It is estimated that there are approximately 50 million cats, 50 million feral cats in the United States. And free-roaming intact cats readily reproduce, and by intact I mean not spayed or neutered. One intact female cat will typically have up to 6 kittens in a litter and 2 litters per year. And it's also known that up to 22% of households feed outdoor cats that they do not own. Many who feed these unknown cats have a very protective bond with the cats that they care for. This is despite the fact that they cannot touch these cats, they cannot pet these cats, but they do feed and care for these cats, and they're very protective of them. Consequently, these individuals may resist efforts to control the feral cat population by lethal means. There are several methods being advocated for feral cat control and solutions to feral cat population problems. The first is to do nothing or to wait and see. Well, we know that we didn't get 50 million feral cats in the U.S. overnight, so I think we know that doing nothing will not solve this problem. Feral cats that are not spayed and neutered will continue to reproduce and their populations will grow. A second method that is often advocated is trap and euthanize, and this is supported by the belief that preemptive euthanasia is better than a life full of hazards and risks. However, this brings up an ethical question. Is it ethically acceptable to destroy healthy animals because they might suffer in the future? Another method that is often advocated is to trap and remove or relocate, and this is advantageous under certain conditions. For example, kittens should not be a part of a feral cat colony. They should be trapped, socialized, and then adopted out into good, loving homes. Also, if cats are endangering endangered species, those cats should be relocated to another location, because now you're considering two populations, the feral cats and the endangered species. Unfortunately, relocation is not something that we can do with every feral cat, because relocation space is very limited. In upstate New York, we only have so many farmers with so many barns able to take so many feral cats. Consequently, the best solution is trap, neuter, return. In this case, feral cats are captured using a humane trap, and contrary to what some people believe, feral cats do go into humane traps, along with owned and stray cats, small dogs, raccoons, skunks, and I've caught a possum on occasion in a feral humane trap. Once these cats are captured, they are taken to a veterinarian where they are spayed and neutered, vaccinated for rabies and upper respiratory viruses, and they're given an ear tip so that they can be identified in the future as having been spayed or neutered. Healthy cats are returned to their location, essentially their home, and sick and debilitated cats are euthanized. Kittens are adopted out through an animal rescue or shelter. TNR is more cost-effective than trap euthanize. A recent study demonstrated that TNR results in an 82% decrease in population at a cost of approximately $130 per cat. On the other hand, trap euthanize results only in a 68% reduction at a cost of approximately $300 per cat. There are several benefits to trap neuter return. The number one benefit is population growth is brought under control. An established sterilized colony will prevent another colony from moving into that location. Time and time again, we have seen situations where a person goes in and traps and removes all of the cats from a location, except unbeknownst to them, 1 to 2 miles down the road is another feral cat colony growing out of control. Once that feral cat colony has exceeded its carrying capacity, it will move down the road into the location that was recently vacated by the cats that were removed. The reason the cats were there in the first place is because there was a ready food source, typically, as I said earlier, a dumpster or an overpopulation of rats or mice. Also, trap neuter return results in less vocalization and spraying of property. It is well known that unspayed, unneutered cats are typically attributed to property damage resulting from spraying as a part of their reproductive activities. Spaying and neutering them will reduce that activity. Also, on a public health front, it reduces rabies transmission. This protects our citizens, especially our children. The 2008 New York State rabies statistics list the four top species that were tested positive for rabies at the Wadsworth Laboratory in Albany. The top four species are raccoons, bats, skunks, and cats. Cats that are participating in a trap, neuter, return program are vaccinated for rabies and therefore will be not part of that rabies vector. This also improves the welfare of feral cats. Those of you who have cats and dogs, you've taken them to the veterinarian, you've probably seen a poster on the wall in the exam room called the Body Condition Score. And this is something that veterinarians use to assess the health and well-being of an animal. Studies have shown that neutered feral cats have a better body condition score and are healthier than intact feral cats. And finally, this provides an opportunity to educate the public about our responsibilities towards animals. Feral cats are a human-created problem. They did not fall from the sky. They didn't land here from outer space. They are a problem that we created, and they are a problem that we need to solve. I'd like to share with you a success story from the University of Central Florida. This was a study of feral cat TNR that was led by Dr. Julie Levy at the University of Central Florida. This campus covers approximately 2.2 square miles, which is considerably smaller than the town of Salina. However, their population is 38,000 students and employees, which is slightly larger than, I think, the last population statistics for the town of Salina. There were 11 feral cat colonies. At the start of the study, there were 155 feral cats, and by the conclusion of the study, through TNR, that population was reduced to 23 feral cats. That is a reduction of nearly 85% of the population. Before TNR was implemented, free-roaming cats were considered a nuisance, particularly by university officials, and the primary complaint was property damage. Also, employees and students were told by university officials to not feed the cats. Many of them disobeyed that order, continued to feed the feral cats, and consequently we had basically fighting going on between these two groups. Initially, the university officials implemented a trap euthanize program. This was not successful for a number of reasons. One was that they were not able to trap all of the feral cats, but also because employees and students that were feeding the feral cats sabotaged their efforts by tripping the traps, by releasing the cats from the traps once they had been trapped, etc. After TNR was implemented, the cat welfare improved. Also, relations between university officials and the employees and students improved because both groups wanted the same goal, which was to reduce the cat overpopulation on campus. This is a win-win for Salina. Salina has a feral cat problem. And I'm not saying that not Salina, everybody has a feral cat problem. But feral cat caretakers have the expertise to manage feral cat colonies. They know how to do trap, neuter, return. And through this, they can reduce and stabilize the population, and they can reduce the number of constituent complaints, which I understand that many of you have been dealing with. This is also a springboard for constituent education. Spay or neutered pet is a happier, healthier pet. In addition, although we've been focusing on feral cats in this presentation, owned cats are also part of this problem. Owned cats that are allowed outdoors, that are not spayed or neutered, they are also adding to this population, and they are also implicated in property damage. So implementing the TNR program and supporting the feral cat caretakers can also educate our constituents about following the law regarding getting their pets spayed or neutered, regarding getting their pets vaccinated for rabies. I'd like to leave you with national support for trap, neuter, return. The American Association of Feline Practitioners, which is an association of feline specialist veterinarians, supports appropriately managed cat colonies. And although the American Veterinary Medical Association neither endorses nor opposes appropriately managed cat colony programs, they do recognize that managed colonies should be considered a part of the solution to the problem of feral, free-roaming cats. And finally, the National Animal Control Association has recently changed their position from supporting trap euthanized programs to now empowering their animal control officers to manage. With feral cat populations, typically they are being cared for by a feral cat caretaker who is providing food and water on a daily basis. A managed colony is where that caretaker is also trapping those cats and having them spayed or neutered and vaccinated for rabies and other respiratory viruses. They're also maintaining the welfare of those cats. They're monitoring their health. Those that are sick.